I really don't want to break the flow of what the Spirit is doing. But as I was sitting there, the Lord brought me to the book of John 7. And it was talking about the feast. And he began to speak about the Holy Spirit had not yet come. But he said, out of your bellies shall flow rivers of living water. And I was reminded, I was sitting there and my mind went back to Grand Junction, Colorado, where we were pastoring. And the church was like a favorite son in the district. And the Lord was using on Tuesday morning the Bible study as a bridge to bring other people in. And I'm telling you, Annette, if you will allow the gifts and the Spirit of the Lord to continue to move in this church, the Lord says it's only just begun. Because you don't have an agenda. I like that. It's what is the Spirit saying. And I was teaching on the river of God. And I'm telling you, ladies, that same feeling is here. There's a river flowing. I dare not interrupt the flow. And I had several ladies, and the Spirit of the Lord, I can see them sitting. And in the back, there was a very dignified little girl. And I was teaching about the river. Her name is Susan Boer. Beautiful blonde. You'd never think, she could never think that the Holy Spirit was going to use her to break open an atmosphere. But as I begin to speak about the river and the power of the Spirit and how he's going to use women in the last days, that's all I can tell you, that God is using women, because women have been suppressed and put down. But he said, I got news for you. I'm raising up an army of women, and they're going to let the Spirit of the Lord flow through them, start ministering in your sphere of influence. And this young girl was sitting back there, and all of a sudden I heard this squeal, and the river hit her, and we had a continual revival because there was a woman who thought she might not be used, but she was hungry, and the river hit her, and we begin to see signs, we begin to see miracles. And I'm telling you, ladies, today, there is a river flowing, and it's got you in mind. And the Lord said, he took me back to McCook, Nebraska, where they saw revival, and people came from miles around. And that's where Smith Wigglesworth preached. But you know what? They preached about the power of the Spirit. They saw signs, wonders, and miracles. But did you know it wasn't Smith who brought it? It was about six ladies who prayed for an outpouring of the Spirit of God, and God heard their prayer. Revival hit, and I'm telling you, Annette Donaldson, revival is about to hit this church. You don't have a nonsense church. You just get to the point, and you say, it's not by might. It's not by power, but it's by my Spirit, says the Lord. And that Spirit is here. That Spirit is wanting to break out. He's wanting to break out in you. That timidity that has had you bound, that's kept you down. The Lord said it's your hour to get up off of the floor, rise, wake up like Deborah. He said, awake, awake. If you don't, we're going to lose a generation. Hallelujah. That word arise. It takes action from you. I heard the speaker last night say, do you want it? Do you want it? We just stood there. Some came forth, some didn't. The Holy Spirit is saying to you, I would like some lights. Because God is getting ready to shine in this congregation and upon this group. That same anointing that raised Jesus from the dead is in this room. It's in this room. That resurrection power that raised him up. And let me tell you, I want to tell you, we're going to flow. We're going to release it. But I want to tell you something. Tomorrow is my birthday. This year is 5776. It's the year that the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ is going to be poured out upon us in a new way. 7-7 is double. Double completion. 6 is the number of man. I said, Lord, it's here. Come on, get loose with me. I said this. I said, Lord, I will be 76 tomorrow in the year 5576 on the day of Pentecost. And let me tell you, I've been asked to speak at a lot of conferences. I'm not a fluff speaker. I only know one thing. If Holy Spirit doesn't show up, you can be as fluffy and cute as you want to, but it ain't gonna do one bit of good. It's just a meeting. Here's what I said in it. I said, Lord, I want on my birthday a new anointing for the new season. We're not in the old, we're in the new. What worked last time is not going to work this time. Because God is shifting us. He is making us. He is letting us move. I said, now, I want a double portion. You stole my thunder. Now listen. Listen closely. I have a passion for the next generation and for women. That is just what I am. And I was at a large meeting. Now you better hear what I'm saying. I've asked for a new anointing. Get it in your head. A double portion. To fall on me. At this meeting. I don't know what I'll look like. I don't know what I'll act like, but I don't care. I lost my reputation a long time ago. Now hear what I'm saying. I've asked for a double portion. For me, I'm selfish when it comes to the things of God. I want my portion. But I don't want just a portion. I want a double portion. Now, I was at a large meeting. My husband and I, we were set in a VIP section, and they walked in Cindy Jacobs. And I was just sitting there. And she was marching in, and she stopped. And she said, "Nancy," she knew my name. She said, "Your children, hear me, will have a double portion. They will have double the anointing that you have." So I began to think, oh, yes, my daughters and my grandsons. He said, "Whoa, whoa, 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 whoa." He said, "It's not just for your little clique, your little family." He says, "It's for your spiritual children also. A double the anointing." Honey, I don't know, but I just feel like that you're just thinking, well, I wonder if that could happen to me. And the Lord says, you're about to get it. He is about to release. Whoa. Shh. Do you want it? Show. So I begin to think like this. If I ask for my birthday a gift of the Holy Spirit, a new anointing, and you're here, and you say, I want a double what she's going to get today. Do you want it? Reach up and get it. This army she was talking about last night. By the way, she stole. I think she got in my room. She got my notes. But can you imagine women of God with a double portion? You are so stinking cute. But I tell you what, God is going to take what you went through last season. It's over. And the Lord said you went through it so that he can use it in this season to bring in. Listen, God is here. Holy Spirit is here. I don't know what she went through, but the Lord says it's over. It's done with. Now he's going to lift her up. For the Spirit of the Lord God is upon her, and he has anointed her to set the captives free. You know, the day of the superstar is over. He is going to the unlikely, into the unlikely places. He's going in and he's saying, if you want it, you can have it. All you got to do is say, I'm ready. Father, that's said, I'm here. Your past is not your future. We're in a new season, a new day. The old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. There is a new package. He has taken what you had left, and he's repackaging it to be used in this new day. What is your name? Kim. Kim, the Lord says, I can use you in places that you never thought that you could be used. You have visions, you have dreams, but you thought you couldn't do it. Well, this new anointing, oh, it's here. This new anointing is going to enable you to get up and go. Kim, shoo. Right. Holy Spirit, sing it. You are welcome here. Come on, we're just gonna flow.
Double portion.
I want my portion.
Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory, Lord.
God is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence.
Do you realize what you just said? Do you realize what you just said? You ask him to fill this atmosphere, to overcome you with his glory. Do we realize sometimes what we say when we're singing? Holy Spirit, charge this place. We'll sing some more. Now last night,
Holy Spirit, you are
last night, then bring me one of those. One of those, yeah. I understand you received the Holy Spirit. You spoke in tongues. You did? Are you sure? You're sure, sure. See, that's what we want. Sure, sure. And you know what? I see all of these little fishes on the back of a car. We are Christian. I have my own emblem. We're spirit filled. Look at us now. Look at us now. We mean business. Devil, move over. I'm taking back what you stole from me in the last season. You stole some stuff from me, and now this is what I am. I'm no longer a little fish just swimming down the stream. I'm mean business for the kingdom of God. Don't you forget who you are. Holy Spirit.
Spirit, you are welcome here.
Double portion.
Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory, Lord.
Your glory, that is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Heard the Lord say this. You women come and you get all charged up. Then you go home and you have to face hell. And the Lord says to tell you, he's moving into the house. He's going to change the atmosphere in your house. Those prodigal kids who give you terrible anxiety, The Lord says, I'm moving in the house. I'm coming into your house. I'm coming into your house. I don't know who you are, but the Lord says, they're coming home. They're coming home. They're coming home. God is coming to your house with his power, with his glory, with his might. In Jesus' name. Charge that house. Holy Spirit. Anybody else? You just say, my house needs to be charged with the glory of God. I'm tired of going home.
The atmosphere.
You mean this.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by
now,
your presence.
I just saw you up
Lord.
At night. Saying, Lord, I don't know how much more this I can take. The Lord says, you took, and you took, and you took. And now he's going to do something about it. Mama's prayers in this season. God says, I heard the prayers. The prayer bowl of heaven is being tipped over your house. And oh, there's going to be an empowering. Your prayer language is going to a new level. A new level. Let it out. Come on. Come on, that's good, but it's come on, that's good. Come on. Whoa. Whoa. Show. Isaiah 52 says, awake, awake, shake yourself. Come on, there's a whole lot of shaking going on in this place. Shake it off. Let me tell you, if you study, and she could probably do it better than me, but I'm not going to let her. You know what? That shaking, it implies, it gives the picture of a lion shaking its mane. Of a lion shaking its mane. God is going to release a lion spirit, not a lion, a lion spirit, a lioness. The new sound in this house will be the roar of the Spirit of the Lord. Oh, mama, mama, mama. You're one of those mamas who knows how to pray. You're one of those mamas that the glory of the Lord just is around you. But there is a refreshing coming your way. You see, it troubles me when I come and I see precious saints of the Lord that is just weary from battle. And the Lord says, I want the refreshing power of the Spirit of God to come upon them and a renewing of your spirit. Father, what's your name? Ophelia, I'm going to ask the Lord. Just stretch your hands out. How old are you? She's going to be 80 in June. 8 is new beginnings. You know, the Lord is certainly not through with you yet. You're kind of like me. I'm 76, and I said, Lord, I think I'll go to 88. And then when I get to 88, I think we'll discuss it then when I want to go home. And you know what I decided? I have a black t-shirt. It's got pink written on it, praying grandma. And when I go, I don't want them foo-fooing me up, putting a corsage on me, putting pearls on me. I don't want them to do that to me. I'm going to go in my praying grandma shirt. Because God is raising up an army of women who says, I'm going to have the anointing. I'm going. I'm God's conquering manifesto. You know what Hitler had the... I like you. You know what Hitler had the guts to say? Give me the mind of the youth, and I will control the future. That made me mad. I said, not on my watch. Girls, I'm 76 tomorrow, and I'm not tired, but I'm telling you, there is a spirit of the Holy Spirit that's coming upon you, and you're going to start taking over some of this. It's not for just Eva to teach and preach. It's for you. That army she talked about last night, they're going to preach. That means to proclaim, decree, to say something. I have something to say. Devil, you are not. You see, we have the authority to draw a line and say, you've come this far, but you can't come any further. I didn't give birth for these kids. I didn't go through the agony and the push and want to claw my husband's eyes out because it hurt. I didn't go through all that. I didn't give birth to them for you to have them. And I'm taking back what belongs to me. My seed belongs to me, not you. My seed belongs to me, not you. My great-grandchildren belong to me, not you. I'm expecting my 10th great-grandchildren, and I'm refiring, and I'm saying, God, they belong to me. How many do you have? 6 kids. Who do they belong to? They belong to God. So, Father, I'm asking for 12 more years and a refreshing for this one. And Father, those 6 kids are going to line up. Jesus' name. There it is. From the crown of her head, we release the joy of the Lord. We break. So, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence. Cause Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. So come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
God is raising up. This generation will complete that which my generation started. I can't imagine in all of my imagination what it's going to look like when your generation gets a hold of the vision. I'm going to change the world because of who lives within me. What is your name? Jade. I have a Jaden, a great granddaughter named Jaden. Do you mean business? I can tell you do. Father, you said, Lord, you're going to pour your spirit out in unprecedented ways in this new season upon women, upon daughters. Joel said, I'll pour my spirit out on my sons and my daughters. They will prophesy. Girl, you're going to prophesy in this new season. You're going to decree a thing and it shall be established. Job said that. The word said it. You will decree. And through the cleanliness of your hands, you'll jerk this generation from the brands of the burning. Lord, I just see an army of redheads. And that redhead, Lord, represents the fire of the Holy Spirit. Yes. That fire of Pentecost. And Father God, let the fire fall upon this one. Man, I see you rocking and rolling. I see you going forth as a mighty woman of God in this season. Setting your generation free. You know what? We have been oppressed by the enemy. Women have. But you're going to be a sign and a wonder to this church.
Yes,
a sign and a wonder. I'm almost afraid to say what I see. But if God used Catherine Kuhlman with signs, wonder, and miracles, I'm here to tell you this with boldness. It's not because he couldn't find a man to do it. It's because he knew that woman was going to get it done. He's going to pour out an anointing upon women in this hour because the enemy knows when we come to the knowledge and we realize who we are in Christ. He knows his kingdom has to come down. So, Father, I thank you for Jade. And the fire of Pentecost, oh God, that's coming upon her. Lord, that river is going to start flowing. Lord, that youth movement in West Virginia, I'm saying, Lord, send it to the Point Church. Send it here and let it go out into the region. And Father God, we thank you that you have Jaden's lined up, Jade's lined up. And this pastor's going to say, you go, girl. We're not going to stop you. Go in the name of the Lord. Go. God means business today. You're just sitting there and you're just wiggling. And you're squirming, and a lot of that is you, but a lot of it's the Holy Spirit saying, it's time to go. It's time to go. It's time to go. Father God, we release her to go in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Well, Joy is her middle name. I just said, God's going to give you joy. She said, Joy is my middle name. So joy is joy unspeakable and full of glory. You received your prayer language last night, but the glory of the Lord is going to invade you everywhere. Everywhere you go, you're going to bring joy from this day forward. If you'll let it flow, if you'll let it flow, we release joy. Oh. Show. Joy, joy. Everybody say, joy, 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 joy. Let it come in this house. See, out of our bellies flow rivers of living water.
Yes.
Sweetheart. You just like those kids, don't you? And I just see you praying over those kids. Let me tell you something. You got a mess on your hands with what's going on, but God says He's going to give you the grace, yes, that power, that dunamis, that ability. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, like you said last night, comes on you with power to be. Yes. To be. That means He gives you the ability to do what you think you couldn't do. Did you know you could start a revival just by laying hands? Father, I'm going to pray a protection over her. A protection, because she hears, she sees a lot of junk. But Father God, I thank you that that's junk. That's just junk. And we say it's gone. It will not just keep going over and over and over in your mind. Because God is putting a crown upon you. And He said, daughter, you are called for such a time as this. Esther wrote a decree. And she signed it. And it was sealed by the authority of the king's ring. She wrote it in the name of the king. And the Lord says, you're going to write a decree for this generation that you minister to in your classroom. You will decree a thing and it will be established, said, yes, the Lord. There it is. Strength in Jesus' name. We need to pray for our teachers. You know, they hear stuff. They see stuff. Any other teachers in this room? Some of them never come to Point Church, but you can send the power home with them. They don't even have to know. You can take them through the cleanliness of your hands. Job said, you will decree a thing and it will be established, and the light will shine upon you. And through the cleanliness of your hands, you can jerk this generation from the branch. Don't send a man into the ladies' restroom. I'm not going to have it for my kids. And you don't have to put up with it either. You have the authority to say no. To get in the face of that thing and say, not on my watch. Because I'm anointed with the power of the Spirit of God. I can change the atmosphere where I teach. When I walk into my classroom, the atmosphere has to shift. When you walk into your workplace because of the Spirit of the living God upon you, You can shift that thing. Yes. You can turn it around. Yes. You can take it for the kingdom of God.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Eva, am I telling them the truth? Are you sure? Just teasing. I know it's the truth.
Amen.
Do you believe what I just told you? That you can change the atmosphere, not only in your classroom. I have something to say. Do you know, everybody is talking about taking the seven mountains. Now, I'm not against that book. But I'm saying, ladies, if we don't take the family mountain, it's going to take our kids to take the other mountains. And that's why the enemy fights our home so bad, because we're going forth as an army in this region, in this state, to take the family mountain back. I have never in my life, everywhere we go, there's divisions, divisions in the family. Mothers, daughters, sons, fathers. Tried to eat yesterday at Furs, and there was a son and a daddy sitting there fussing. Well, you found me as a father. Well, you didn't do this. Well, let me tell you, it made me mad. I said, listen, I don't want to hear this right now. Because we have a mandate to take back the family mountain to put a stop to a lot of this stuff that's going on. And I begin to study, and it is a proven fact, it doesn't take a multitude of people to take a mountain. A proven fact, it takes 3 to 5% who are truly committed. And I'm telling you, you can be committed to taking this generation, but I'm going to tell you, with the power of the Spirit of God that's coming upon you, there is no stopping this army that God is raising up. Can you imagine an army of females marching to the cadence of the Holy Spirit? Hearing the voice of the Spirit, hearing the voice of the Father, and in one, marching, march with me. Give me marching music. Come on. Can you imagine an army of females marching in unity? I don't care what you think of me. I've tasted of the goodness of the Lord. I'm taking the family mountain. For the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. I don't have anything within myself. But when I hear the Spirit of the Lord say go, I'm going. Come on. Get the picture. Army marching to the cadence of the Spirit. I declare that these ladies in this church, I declare the Spirit of the Lord is upon them, for He hath anointed, He hath appointed, call them forth for such a time as this. Imagine with me, not just a bunch of silly females, but women who say, I'm part of the army of God. You can't stop me, for the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Get the picture. Women march. Christian. Women declare it. Women speak in the mind of Christ. I'm shaking my mane. I'm shaking my mane. The new sound is coming forth from me. What the Lord said. As a prophetic act, some of you don't even have shoes. Hear me. I'm a prophetic act person. When you do a prophetic act, you're declaring it's not this anymore, but it's this. The Lord said, you do a prophetic act, you change your shoes and put your war boots on. Do it. Just start doing it. However you got, whatever you have to do, you're making a statement. I'm taking my foo-foo shoes off. When I grew up, Nancy Sinatra had a song.
How these boots are made for walking.
She was talking about a man, but she said, these boots. And one of these days, I'm going to walk all over you. I'm here to tell you, you just did a prophetic act. And you said, devil, these boots are made for kicking. And I'm getting ready to kick you out of my house. That's what these boots are for. You have Toms on. Those aren't boots. You know what? Your sin right here. Your sin. A picture of the generations. The next generation. They need me. They need my wisdom. But I need their strength. I need them to do what I cannot do. I'm huffing and puffing, but it's okay. She's not. But I'm telling you what, the same spirit that's in me is in her, will be in her children. My great-grandchildren are going to speak in tongues. They're going to prophesy. I have to declare that over them every day. You know why? Because Joel said, your sons and your daughters, if they're born into a preacher's family, a missionary's family, they'll prophesy? No. He said, I'm going to pour my spirit out upon your sons and your daughters. They will prophesy. They will declare. They will decree. They will be the queens. You see, we're so used to praying. But God says, you're seated with me now. You have authority. I'm going to tell you what to say, and you will decree it, and it will be so. So do you have your boots on? Did you know that if an army is marching, they march in unison?
That's right.
Okay. Do you realize that if they come to, I believe it's called a drawbridge, they have to break rank? Because if they march across that bridge in unison, it will cause the bridge. Am I correct? Is it a drawbridge? What kind of bridge is it? So if that army, that's how strong unity is. If they come to a bridge, and I've been taught, you know, it's one of those, like the Grand Canyon, it will cause the bridge to fall. That's how strong unity is. This army that God is raising up, it's not just a little army. It's a powerful force to take the kingdom of God. He said, shake off the things that has kept you bound in the last season. It's a new day. And when you're shaken, remember, God is releasing that anointing on you to roar in the face of your enemy. Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
It's a new day, Annette. It's a new day for this church. With your permission, I feel like I have to release the roar over each one of you. And when God gets through with you, you're not going to be the same. A friend of mine had a dream, and she's not a flake, so I feel I can share it. I'll quit. In this dream, she said that she was driving this huge 18-wheeler truck. It was shiny and it was new, so she knew that it hadn't been driven before. But she said, on either side of the road was padded bumpers, or whatever they are, rails, padded rails. And she said she would drive it. And she said, as I was driving that truck, I would hit it because I didn't yet know how to drive it. But I'd get it back on the road, and I'd go to the left. I'd hit it. But she said, I had so much joy driving the new, but I couldn't really understand how to drive it. Mm-hmm. And she said, but the joy was there. And she said, then I heard a voice behind me. And he said, Tiffany. And I'm saying, ladies at the Point Church, you have 2 days to learn how to navigate this truck, this new. And the 2 days represented the double anointing that he's going to give people in the new season. We don't know how to do it all yet. He has given us protection as we're learning, but he's given us 2 days to learn it. In other words, he's given you the double anointing to know how to navigate through this new season. Are you ready? Yes. Annette, I just feel like I got to do it. You have your boots on. Yes. She taught you last night. But I tell you, I am going with the permission of the Lord and the power of the Holy Spirit. I want to activate that double anointing, that marching anointing, that army anointing, that Deborah anointing, that Esther anointing, that joy of the Lord, that strength. Are y'all tired? You know what? I have wanted to come to this church for a long time. I got to come. And for you to be here, you're one of my favorite worship guys. I prophesied over you, that's how. Rick Pino's. Oh, I had such an impact on him. Whoa. Sam Brassfield's wife. Yeah.
Well, you did have an impact.
I did. I know. That man can play any instrument. It amazes me. But it's not his ability. It's the anointing. There's a lot of people with ability don't mount to a hoot. Ability without anointing. What are you laughing about? Yesterday, I have to be truthful with you. And I'll share a little bit more. I'm going to let you go in just a minute. I'll share a little bit more this afternoon, what I've had to come out of. I mean, I've come out a lot. But you know, when you're married to a prophet, this lady is a walking Bible. And I'm married to one. Sometimes I go. And sometimes when he releases stuff, it goes, doing. But we are a team, as it should be. And every now and then somebody will come and say, what did he mean? Oh, I'll tell you what he meant. He just meant, God is raising up an army, and they're going to prophesy and declare, As simple as that. But he'll take them from Genesis to Revelation. Name every woman in the Bible. Describe her household. Describe what she did for dinner last night. And that's good. And so when we go to these conferences, you know, he has such really pretty white hair. And he always gets a word. Always. I say it's your hair. It's not God, it's your hair. No. And sometimes I sit there and I say, well, Lord, I'm here. And I'll get a word. One of them, Barbara Wintrouble, prophesied, and she said, you're 1/4 pastor. And then she went on, and I thought, well, what am I? This other 3/4. Then I go to another place. I get a word. I see you like, you're just one that goes up the slide backwards. So yesterday, I got a little intimidated. And actually, it wasn't because of the speaker. It was because of Annette. I wasn't quite sure I knew what I was. I'm a little out there. And I thought, this lady here looks so dignified. And I'm 1/4 pastor. I have to go up the slide backwards. So, Annette, I was really kind of, because I know if I go there, I might mess up stuff. And I text somebody, and they said, and it's a good friend of yours, very kind, I think she's a little out there too. So that helped. And then I got to thinking, was it 3 weeks ago we were here for the regional thing? And we began to, you know, talk, and Sam and I had to leave early. And as I was leaving, I heard this song. We eat giants for our bread. And I thought, how weird is that? I fit in just fine, because I like giant meat. I've had to overcome a few. You're looking at a woman who is a memorial to the faithfulness and the promises of God Almighty. I've had to eat a few giants. Some of them didn't want to come down, but Annette, they got to bow to the authority. Did you ever eat giant meat? See, you think that she's all, she never had a battle. She's a living memorial to show that God is upright and faithful to his promises. You're looking at one, I know the faithfulness of God. She got up last night. She said, I have an accent. I thought, so do I. I'm from Central Texas. And I've had to retrain myself to say, God is getting ready to move. But if I really said it correctly, listen, ladies, God is fixing to move in this place in such an unprecedented way. You're not even going to know yourself. when he gets through with you, because God's fixing to do it. So I thought, okay, I fit in. I got an accent. This is the truth. Cheryl Ballard called me. She said, I've got a word for you. The Lord showed me what to tell you. I thought, finally, I'm going to get a word. Cheryl's going to give me a word. You know what my word was? She said, Nancy, I see you as a wooden spoon. I said, a wooden spoon? What do you mean? She said, my grandma had a wooden spoon. And she said, I said, well, I know what wooden spoons are for. And the Lord said, no. She said, what I am telling you is God is sending you in as a wooden spoon. And he said, God is cooking some things up. He's getting ready to stir women up. And if you don't use the wooden spoon to get the keep it off of the bottom, it's going to burn and destroy the rest of the meal. And then I heard the Lord say recently, you know, they say all these hacks, I think they call it cooking kitchen hacks. If you put a wooden spoon on the top of a boiling pot, it won't boil over. Hear me. Hear me. God said, Holy Spirit just spoke to me. And he said, some of you, someone put a wooden spoon on you that's keeping you from letting the Spirit of God flow. And he says, I am fixing to remove that spoon. And the Spirit of the Lord is going to overflow in such manners. So I may not get a pretty wooden prophecy. But I'm telling you what. If I can stir you up to be what God called you to be in this season, I have done my job. The wooden spoon anointing is about to flow in this room now. Sing it. Just line up. You don't have to, it doesn't matter. We're an army dressed for battle.
You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land, take the land.
You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land.
Come on, you're an
take
army.
The land. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land, take the land.
Come on, you're an army.
You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land.
All
the weapons of our warfare, they are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. Oh, the weapons of our warfare. They are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. Oh, the weapons of our warfare, they are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. Oh, the weapons of our warfare, they are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. They are mighty through our God. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land. Take the land. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land. Giant's head. We need giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. We cut off the giant's head. We eat giants for our bread. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land. Take the land. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land. He's a mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior. He's a mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior. He's a mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior, mighty, 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 mighty warrior.
one of his generals in this army. The Lord's calling you up higher to declare his word, not only in this house, but in the region. Not only in the region, but the state. Not only in the state, but the nations. Not only in the nation, but the nations. The Lord says you're the glue that keeps this thing together. And the Lord said, all of those women of old that you've studied, the Lord said those mantles are for yours to grab hold of. And that Catherine Kuhlman anointing. But most of all, I see you going to the nations and bringing deliverance. The Lord said that mantle required to bring deliverance is coming upon you now. It's not just a little anointing. It's going to pale the past moves of God, what God is fixing to do in this house. The house of the Lord. The point, the no-nonsense church is getting ready to be invaded by the Spirit of the living God. And it's starting with you, Annette Donaldson. It will go to your seed. It will go to your seed. Not one of them will be lost. Lord, I decree the youth in this church are coming forth. And I declare over this one, the Deborah, you've got to rise up. Deborah, you've got to rise up. Take the mantle. If you don't, but you will, the Lord said. You've said, Lord, if you can use anything, you can use me. And the Lord said, this day I am mantling you with a mantle for the new season that we don't know what it's going to be like, but you will care. God. Oh, God's in this place. You will see a need, and you're speaking to that need with a prophetic song. How to steward this revival that's coming. It's not if it's come, it's here. In the past, somebody has put the lid on it and said it can't be done. It has to be done this way. God has chosen you to steward this thing, both here and abroad. And the Lord said, I am going to refresh you. And when you get up, change your walk. You're going to go in with renewed strength. Renewed strength for battle. Lord, she's done much. She's carried the mantle. Oh, Lord, I'll remove the old. Look at her face. Now, Lord, the new mantle. I need somebody, a seasoned intercessor for the intercessors. Suzanne, pray over her feet. I don't want anyone touching her. God is renewing our strength for battle.
You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. So take the land, take the land. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. You're an army dressed for battle. Take the land.
I don't know who you are, but there's a new anointing coming, a war beat that's going to open the heavens over this church. Lord, let it start now. Start now. Start now. Start now. Start now. Start now. Listen. Stir it up. Stir it up. Now listen. Listen to that beat. The Lord says angels are descending at this very moment to the drum beat. They've been waiting to come. I'm telling you, ladies, you better reach up. You better grab it, because that double anointing has just entered this room. Grab it, grab it, grab it. Over here to my left. It's at my left. It's at the left. It's at my left. Grab it. There it is. There it is. Ho, ho, ho. Hear the drum beats. The army of the Lord. Hear. The Lord said, hear the voice of the Lord. Listen, you're not likely to forget that sound, because it's a sound from heaven. Whoa, there it is. Whoa, oh, I feel it. I feel it. Do you feel it? There it is. There it is. of thunder. Oh, the roar. Afraid to give birth to the new thing. The Lord said, son, there's an anointing coming upon you to birth the next generation. And the Lord said, he has given you keys. He's given you authority. He says, now use it. Use it. You're more than a catcher. You're more than a catcher. You're a minister of the word of God. You're an armor bearer. But you're anointed to take it. You protect this pastor. God's going to give you strategies. He's going to give you revelation of the word that you've never had before. You're going to get a revelation. You're going to go to pastor and say, pastor, this is what I heard. This is what's going to happen. It'll even surprise you in this hour. Are you ready? Spirit of wisdom, revelation, there it is. God, I thank you that he thinks that he can't do it. But I thank you that you said, when the Holy Ghost comes upon you, you'll be his witness. Signs. You said, Lord, could you use these hands for signs, wonders, and miracles? They'll be astonished at what you do. To the humility and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. There it is. Thank you.
to go with the spoon in us. We're done.
Oh, glory to God. He's so beautiful. Isn't he beautiful? He's so beautiful. I just saw the Lord release the ladder. Did somebody say ladder? I don't even know. I saw the Lord release the ladder over this region. And you just say, Kirsten, come up. Say bye. We're breaking for lunch. Oh, Nancy has a gift for us. Amen.
Sometimes when we go to conferences, we get blessed. We get blessed. And we go home, and then when we get home, the enemy tries to talk us out of it. The Lord instructed me to make a bracelet called Empowered. Sometimes before we go home, we'll talk about the 22-22 and then the 2-2-2-2, the four twos. And I wanted to do this, Annette. Purple is a special color. Would you just pass these out for me? I think I've had it. And I want to see this. These things are so... Body one, I don't know what to do. I don't want to sell them. I don't. The little girl who received the Holy Spirit last night, I want to make sure she gets one. Okay. Every one of you are powerful ladies. I don't know how many I have, but to me, this is a picture. You see all these little beautiful fish on the back of cars, and, well, I'm a Christian. Well, let me tell you, after Holy Spirit gets through with you, this is what you are. This is what you are. This is what you are. You men, I'm telling you, God is going to raise up some men in this hour. I don't know what to do. I don't know if I have enough. Leave it up to you. I think I might want one. Do you want one? I don't care. Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus, get up and walk. Ooh.